Shalom from Jerusalem. I'm here at the TBN studio watching over walls of Jerusalem, empty walls. Those days Jerusalem shall be full of people, full of life and movement, but there is very few people because of coronavirus. And I want to read scriptures for you. Yesterday we were reading Haggai chapter 2 verse 5 about Passover and covenant. Do not fear, do not be afraid. And now I will read verse 6. For thus says the Lord of hosts, once more I will shake heaven and earth, the sea and dry land. I will shake all nations, and they shall come to the desire of all nations, and I will fill this temple with glory, says the Lord of hosts. Praise the Lord. That's amazing scripture. Show us that God actually going to shake nations, he's going to shake earth and heaven. And we have same prophecy of Jesus in the book of Luke chapter 21, book of Revelations, and many other scriptures. But here we can see not only shaking of the earth and heaven, but also shaking of the nations. And I can tell you for sure, my dear brothers, the coronavirus, or because of coronavirus, God get his attention, and I have lots of testimonies for that. But I can also see in the Bible that all these events, difficult events, eventually the shaking of nations will be used by God to show his glory. Bible speaking obviously about glory of God. So it's a call for us, here in Jerusalem, there in your land and your nation, to be ready to prepare ourselves, because better day of glory of God are coming. And sometimes they come maybe in the way, not in the way we imagine, but it's coming. So we shall be ready, we shall be encouraged, and think, how can we serve the Lord? How we can be blessing for the nations? So that's the word of encouragement from Jerusalem. And I'm praying for you. I'm praying for comfort of the Holy Spirit, for wisdom how to act in those days, but also for inspiration of God and new ideas of God. What can I do for you, Lord, in those historical days? Shalom from Jerusalem.